joy that we gather here as a community. To guests and visitors who are with us today, we extend our warmest welcome. Greetings as well to our home viewers. For those who are with us today, please take time to turn off all cell phones, pagers, games, and other electronic devices. Thank you. Our hymns this morning can be found on the video screens. For those joining us from their homes, please download a copy of the worship aid found in the church website, www.st-mm.com. We have a few announcements that I would like to bring to your attention. A secure and convenient way to contribute to our offerings is online giving. Online donations can be made at any time from the comfort of your own home or any place with internet access. If you don't have online giving, you can still drop the offering in the box located at the entrance of the sanctuary or drop off at the parish office. This weekend's second collection is for Catholic communications. The essential mission of the collection is to contribute to the process of evangelization by fostering activities concerning television, radio, internet, and other media, and through special projects of the Catholic Press. For updated information, don't forget to visit our parish website and sign up for Flocknote at www.st-mm.com. As we prepare for the entrance processional, together let us sing number 545, a hymn of glory. Let us sing number 545.
Hymn of glory, let us sing. New songs throughout the world shall ring. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ by a road before untrod, ascends unto the throne of God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The holy apostolic band upon the Mount of Olives stand. Alleluia, alleluia. And with his faithful followers he, the Lord ascends in majesty. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning, Father.
And happy solemnity of the Ascension. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Ascension. And in the liturgy, we hear a commandment and a reassurance from the ascending Christ. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations. And I am with you always. We cannot do the first without the second. In ascending to heaven, it becomes possible for Jesus Christ to be with the church always and everywhere, rather than in just one place and time. May our prayer today be one of thanksgiving for this wonderful gift of his presence. And so to prepare ourselves to celebrate this great mystery of the ascension of Christ into heaven, let us first of all call to mind our sins and ask God for mercy and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are the eternal Son of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your presence fills the universe. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you guide us home with you into bright glory. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God, the glory of God, the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving for the ascension of Christ, your Son, in our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him right from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne, two shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth. God mounts his throne, two shouts of joy, trumpets for the Lord. announce his throne amid shouts of joy. The Lord amid trumpets blasts. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. For King of all the earth is God. Sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May your eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call. What are the riches of his glory in his inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accordance with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." My brothers and sisters in Christ, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus. The ascension of Jesus is a very important part of the Paschal mystery of Christ. The Paschal mystery, the work of our salvation that began with his passion, but especially his resurrection, and then his ascension into the glory of God the Father. Even though it is a unity, but the church celebrates each aspect with special solemnity. And so the church gives us time to assimilate, to digest one aspect of the Paschal mystery of Christ before the other. And for the past several weeks, the liturgy invites us to celebrate, first of all, the resurrection of Christ. And then his resurrection now leads to his ascension. In the readings, in the scriptures, each of the gospel presents some aspect of the ascension of Christ. Without many of them not giving details in terms of time and exactly how it took place, because that was not their, that was not what they sought to communicate. The evangelist Luke was more generous. Luke wrote the Gospel of Luke and the second half of it, which is the Acts of the Apostles. He was very elaborate. He described using image, that will enable us to grasp the reality of the ascension of Christ, much more vividly. When you enter the church, there was a very beautiful picture of the ascension there. The church has a tradition of using images. Images help us to kind of, get into the deeper reality, because we are humans. Knowledge, as we are told, begins from the senses. So the church artists, Christian artists, have helped us to explain, in an image form. So given that beautiful painting of the ascension of Christ, we see the angelic creatures all at the foot of Christ, ready to, as it were, to lift him up. I have another one that is even much more exciting to me. That one is Jesus was, as it were, launched like a rocket launches, into space, our spacecraft. Well, that is to enable us to grasp what the ascension meant. It was a lifting up. It was a lifting up to the Father. And that lifting up can only be understood for us humans in terms of space. You know, from here to the skies, that is going up, isn't it? So, but we have to ask, the manner of presentation, the images, should lead us to ask, what is the fundamental of this ascension of Christ? What is the deeper religious meaning of the ascension? The big word is, what is the theological sense? But what is the deeper religious meaning which we should grasp, not just remain on the surface of images? It is about the exaltation of Christ, the glorification of Christ. Remember the movement of Christ in this incarnation. Christ seems to step down below to our own dimension as humans. And having accomplished his works of salvation, now he takes an upward movement, his glorification, back to the Father. And so, essentially, the ascension is the glorification of God the Father. Put in our own human language, the return back to God. The return here does not signify living in such a way that he becomes absent, of course. That is not it. But in Christ's ascension, he returns back to the Father as a process, as a necessary process of his glorification, without living in a sense of being completely absent. The gospel today gives this assurance after he gave them the mandate, I am with you always. Jesus, in a real sense, never departed as such, but his glorification and exaltation meant being lifted up to the Father with implications. The implication is that, well, he was no longer visible to our physical eyes. He disappeared, as it were. The disciples could no longer encounter him physically as they used to, because he had been fully glorified and he is now back to God the Father. The early church celebrates this exaltation of Christ with beautiful titles. They see Christ, they glorify Christ as King. King, even though he, you know, the kingship of Christ has some reference to the Davidic king of the Old Testament, but when Christ was exalted, he becomes king of the universe. Not just king of one single nation. He becomes king, he becomes judge of the universe. In those days of monarchy, you know, the basic function of the king is also to judge. And those days, you know, the law is actually the king, to show the power of the king. Yes, Jesus has assumed his power as God in his ascension to the Father. The scripture even makes reference that when he goes back, he is seated at the right hand of the Father. Beautiful human image, you know. The right side, right hand, powerful hand of God the Father. That symbolizes what Christ became after his exaltation. And he becomes Lord. The word Lord, which original ancient Greek word that was used for Christ, Kyrios, was very unique. The Jews at the time of Christ never associate lordship with, because the tendency could pluralize God, which is terrible for them. But here you have the Christian community looking upon Christ as Kyrios, as Lord, as divine. Subsequently, the church will have to have a lot of debate about the identity of Jesus. They look back again to the faith of the early church. What did they believe of Christ? At his ascension, his glorification, he was Kyrios, Lord, and therefore divine. And that helped. That simplified matters. The church believes in the lordship of Christ, universal lordship of Christ. And that comes, that is highlighted by the mystery of his exaltation, by the mystery of his ascension back to the throne of God. And so the church, the Christian community, we capture this moment and celebrate, because it has a lot of implication for us believers. One, because Jesus is intimately united with his disciples, with his believers. He forms one body. And therefore, the body and the head are intimately linked. And so the church celebrates the exaltation of the head as a body. So, it is a feast of great joy, the feast of the ascension, the exaltation of Jesus Christ to his rightful place at the right hand of God, with power, after he has, as it were, accomplished the Paschal mystery, won salvation for mankind, defeated the power of evil, he now assumes that universal kingship and lordship at the right side of the Father. So we, as his body, we rejoice. We rejoice, first of all, like earlier mentioned, the body and the head form one entity. And so the head is glorified. Should the body not rejoice? So that is the joyful character of the feast of the Ascension. But secondly, the ascension of Christ, which explains his exaltation and glorification, is also a sign of hope. A sign of hope, because that glorification process is what God has destined for all of us as disciples of Christ. He himself, you know, in his teaching before his departure, he told them, "I am going to prepare a place for you. I'm going ahead. You will come later." And so we are pilgrims on a journey. And that is the foundation of our Christian hope, that At the end of our lives, we shall all be exalted and glorified with Christ. So, the celebration of the Ascension has a very important implication for us in our lives. It rekindles our hope as we keep before us the life of Christ exalted as our future destiny. We live in this world, but we must, as Christians, fundamentally have an orientation that looks beyond this world. Because where Christ is, our Lord, our King, there we hope to be. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God,
maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
He rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Christ is seated in heaven at the right hand of God. We now pray to the Lord Jesus, asking that he intercede on our behalf.
That the Pope, bishops, priests, deacons, and all church leaders will inspire us by their apostolic activity on behalf of the poor and disenfranchised, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who exercise political power will work together to conserve the precious resources of the earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dearly departed brothers and sisters who gave their lives in the service of their country, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may help families with men and women in the armed forces to cope with the daily challenges in the absence of their loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are in need of the many services our church is called to provide, especially those who are hungry and homeless, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the sick will know the healing power of the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those graduating from high school, college, or other institutions, as they reflect on their accomplishments and take on new challenges, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Sydney and Effie Thibodeau, Arcidio and Ada Allens, and Jean Johnson, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Loving Father, your Son reigns with you. Let us recite together the prayer at the time of the coronavirus. Comfort us, O Lord, for we are like your disciples on the storm-tossed sea. Unsettled by what lies ahead,
we turn to you, our healer and guide,
to still our hearts in our time of need
and hear our prayer.
Heal those who are sick with the coronavirus
and protect the elderly and most vulnerable.
Give strength to all who tend to our health
and wisdom to researchers who work towards a cure.
Open our eyes and hearts
as you did during the hurricane Harvey,
that we may look beyond our immediate needs
to care for others who need help.
Through the Holy Spirit, guide our leaders
to make wise decisions
for the welfare of all the people they serve.
Grant eternal rest to those who died from the virus.
May Mary, our mother,
who has heard our pleas in the storms of our lives,
intercede to our Son
that we may find healing
and a prompt end to this illness.
Mary, star of the sea, pray for us.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior,
heal us.
Loving Father, your Son reigns with you in glory, interceding on our behalf at your right hand. Hear the prayer of your people, voiced in his name, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Please join us in singing number 543, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise, number 543.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplications, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, the King of Glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens, as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator of God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident in following where he, the head and father, has gone before us. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exalt in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, George, his auxiliary, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Mary Magdalene, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Please join us in singing number 683, Be Not Afraid, followed by the Second Communion song, number 721, Eye Has Not Seen. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand.
Body of Christ. Thank you.
Behold, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allowed those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is in to go in peace and love to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing number 769, Go Make of All Disciples, number 769.